tell you a story about the house went blue. I come home one Friday, had to tell the landlady I done lost my job. She said, that don't confront me, long as I get my money next Friday. Now next Friday I come, I didn't get the rent.
What's up, YouTubers? Today's video, we're gonna talk about must-have dirt bike tools and supplies. So, if you're thinking about buying a dirt bike, or if you already have a dirt bike, and you don't have a lot of tools to work with, this is some of the stuff that you're gonna need to work on your dirt bike. So, first off, I wanna start with, micrometer set, and these are not cheap tools, guys. These are pretty expensive. I paid like $250 for this set. And you can use these tools right here, these special tools, to measure the diameter of your pistons, things like that. I also got some feeler gauges, a couple different ones, as you can see. I got three sets of them, and you can use these to measure valve clearances and stuff like that. I also got a digital caliper right here. And I use this to measure my chain slack and my chain tension on the rear tire. Another thing you're gonna need to have is a torque wrench. Must have torque wrenches, because the torque specs are very important on dirt bikes, and they're very sensitive to over tightening and night tightening, because the bolts can come loose and come out, and then you're kind of screwed when you're out in the field. So a torque wrench is a must have. A couple different size ratchets that I got. I got a 1/4 inch and a 3/8 right here. Some screwdrivers. I got a couple of them. I use these small ones right here for my my air screw, but I just bought a extended screw, so I don't have to worry about these no more. But some screwdrivers are always good. I got a torque adapter. This is a Motion Pro right here, and I use this to tighten down cylinder jugs. You're gonna need one of these. Another tool that I got is for your clutch and your brake cable. Or your clutch and your throttle cable, I'm sorry, to lube your cables. And this too is a Motion Pro right here, and this is a good tool to have. For changing out tires, you're gonna need a, they call it a bead buddy. I've never used it, I just got this. So this is gonna come in real handy to use. Also, if you're changing tires, you're gonna need tire spoons. And I got three of them right here. You can get by with two, but I like to have three just to help out, and you know what I'm saying? So another tool that you're gonna need is a spark plug wrench. This is an MSR, so this is a good tool to have for spark plugs. Exhaust spring tool, because they're a pain in the ass to get off and on. So I can't remember where I got this, but this helps me out when I'm doing exhaust springs. So you can need one of these. If you got an air compressor, a tire chuck is always a good thing. A drill, so you don't have to ratchet all of your bolts off. You can just use this and just get it off faster. So a drill is good to have. This is a patch kit for tires, for your inner tubes. And this is a must have. So gonna need one of these too. Good to have. When I'm working on carburetors and stuff, I like to have a magnet tray. That way I don't lose none of my bolts or my screws and things like that. So one of these is very handy to have. Another good tool to have is a compression tester, because you always want to check the integrity of your engine. So a decent compression tester is also good to have. And that's about it for my tools. Oh, here's some sockets right here. Most of the bikes are all metric. So this is a 1/4 inch socket set. So these are good to have too. And that about sums it up for my tools. I'm a mechanic by trade. So I already have most of the tools that I need to do the job. So, but if you guys don't have any of the tools, this is some of the stuff that you're gonna need in order to work on your dirt bike if you're a do-it-yourselfer. So that's it. On to the next. So this is some of the stuff that I've gotten throughout the years from riding my dirt bike. I've got a spare inner tube to the rear, and you're going to need one of these because you never know when you're going to get a flat tire. And when you do that, you just want to go on ride again. So a spare inner tube is good. I got some grease right here for all the bearings and the pivot points on your dirt bike, and the triple clamps, stuff like that. Always carry a extra spark plug too. I got some air filter cleaner right here and some oil. Always take care of your air filter. And this is kind of a mixture of some of the stuff that I've been trying for the gas mix. I got the AMS oil and the Caster 927. My dirt bike really likes this stuff. It smells good too, so. You're gonna need a measuring cup, one of these. For the chain, I recommend cleaning the chain and lubing the chain at all times. So this is what I use for my chain. I got a spare tire because I'm always ripping through stuff and getting crazy out there, so a spare tire is always good. I use this brush right here for cleaning my my chain, and it does a pretty good job too. And I also got a power washer because I got tired of going to the car wash, so I bought my own power washer to take care of it and clean it up. Some packing. If you're a two-stroke guy, you're going to need some packing for your exhaust. I also got a bolt kit just for my dirt bike. It comes with different sizes and whatnot. You know, that's always good to have because you never know when you're going to lose bolts to your plastics and whatnot. Transmission gear oil. My dirt bike likes this stuff, and I really like this stuff, so this is what I use. For the throttle and the clutch, you're going to want to use some white lithium grease. You can use other stuff too if you want to, but this is what I use to lube my cables and keep them free and they don't stick real bad. And this is what I use for my octane booster. This stuff is awesome, dude. Really gives a nice throttle response, faster. It's cleaner, it burns better, and it's just awesome. You're gonna need some brake fluid because it always gets low and you always have to go through brake pads. So this is for Yamalube, and I own a YZ250, so this is what I use for my brake fluid. Some rags. Always use rags because I'm a do-it-yourselfer and I like to do stuff myself instead of paying somebody else to do something that I could do myself. So dirt bike stands. This is another stand that I got. This was my first one right here, but throughout the years I've bought a couple of them. And this one's real good. I like to use this one a lot when I'm power washing my dirt bike and things like that. And a pump for tires. When you get a flat tire, you want a pump so you can air up your tire, or you can use an air compressor. But if you don't have an air compressor, you can use a pump. And that's about it, guys. Just remember, if you out there riding and you don't have extra supplies, then that you're gonna need this kind of stuff to ride, so, and take care of it. So that's it, that's my video for today. So hope you guys liked it, and we'll see you next time.